We have a bunch of this tall, just viney vine stuff. You got a creek in front of us right here. And then that's where we're going. Look how thick that is in there. You got all these trees here. But we're gonna try to see if we can get over here. You can just see how thick it is here. I cut a little bit of this stuff in the summertime, but it's still super thick. Deer are actually using it. You can see a run right here. Let's see if we can get across without falling in. You can see how thick and just disgusting this is to walk through. I mean, look at this run right here. Beautiful run right there. I want to get deeper in over there by that sun. That's where I'm looking to go, but ooh-wee, look at this run. Well, there's a reason why you come in and you scout places rather than coming in blind. This would have been a lot worse if it was tomorrow morning I came in here blind and set up, because dang, I just sunk through a whole bunch of muck. Last time I was in here in the late summer, it wasn't deep and it wasn't mucky, but we've had a lot of rain and look at what I just freaking did. Crossing this looks like an easy way to cross. Yeah. Nice, huh? Just what I wanted. I am frozen now. Some of the sticks all grossed up. God dang it. But as you can see, look how thick it is in here. It is just super thick in here. And it looks like it would be perfect just for bedding and browse and cover for these deer. So that's what we're going to do. I mean, we're about 250 yards in right now off our access point from our private property here. This area here is just free range, but I don't see anybody else in here. I don't see any hunter pressure in here, any traffic, any sign of hunting, nothing. So let's find a tree and let's get set up. All right, guys, we found our tree. There's a little opening right in here. You can see, but we're going to be going right up to that notch up in that tree. So from this view, guys, we have a nice opening in here. Beautiful opening. We just put a trail camera right there for right now, but there's a huge run coming through here. And I don't know if you guys can see, but that is our tree right up there. It just screams deer habitat in here. There's plenty of browse, there's plenty of cover. I mean, this is what I was talking about, how I said we're 300 yards in. Look at how thick that is in there. You can't even walk through that. You disturb everything. The only opportunity we really had was to get on that high stem count, this little open, less stem count, and get right on that transition edge where there's runs coming through here. And hopefully we can seal the deal and get on something here. We're looking to fill the freezer, last year of the season, hopefully. And it's been a good season so far. So let's see what we can get into. So that was deer. They're funneling right through here. And right through here, right behind us. But they're also funneling right through here. And right through here. another run going right through here. Got a nice creek, so we have a nice water source. There's plenty of browsing here for them. And then right up there is a big oak ridge with plenty of acorns.
All right, guys, we are back up in the saddle, same spot we were yesterday morning. It's the 16th right now. It's 1:45 in the afternoon. Deer are up on their feet. I had a doe come through here about an hour ago. Snuck in here pretty good, didn't get bumped or anything like that. We have a northwest wind, which is very good for this spot. It's not bad at all. We're only on doe patrol here. We're already tagged out in mass. Just want to say thank you to everybody who subscribed and is along on this journey. It's been a fun year, and hopefully we can punch another tag tonight. You know, I've donated 5 out of my 6 deer this year to people in need, whether it was due to illness, hardship, or just guys that have not been able to get out in the woods at all this year. So I'd like to punch another tag, fill my freezer, and I'd be really excited about that. But a big shout out to my buddy Sean too. I let him hunt my family property this morning and hammered a nice 8-pointer. So that's what it's all about. It's about everyone helping each other out and being happy for everyone's success. You don't see that much anymore. And, you know, I'm a firm believer in, you know, giving back, and, you know, good karma comes to those that give. So it's a beautiful evening, and I got a really good feeling. That must have been that buck we heard the other morning when it was too dark. Because after going back and listening to the footage, the grunting was definitely an immature buck grunt, for sure.